So far in SolidWorks, we've been using the basic extrude tool. Oftentimes, we also want to be able to make parts that are going to be made on a lathe or via some turning process. And when we do this, we actually want to use a different tool that's called the revolve tool. In revolve, we can sketch the profile of a part and then revolve it about a central axis. So to get started, let's start on a new part. Once I'm in my new part, I can select a plane and open up a new sketch on it. Now what I'm going to want to do is draw the rough outline of what my part will look like. And I'm just going to go ahead here and I'll draw something, a pulley similar to the one that I had before. And maybe this is just a single V-belt pulley, but then it has kind of a cone shape down to a flat and comes across. Okay. And looks like I missed a line here, so I'll go back and add that in with the line command. And before I start dimensioning, it's a good idea to add all my sketch relations. So I want these two lines to always be horizontal and to be collinear. Let's see, I want these. I think that's about all the relations that I'm going to put on it at this time, and I can start dimensioning. So I'll make my V-belt channel. I'm going to make it a 22 degree belt. And I can put some dimensions on how big I want this to be. I'll make it 3 inches, make it a big pulley here. And notice that my drawing now dropped below the origin. I'm going to want to move my drawing up a bit here so I can just click and drag and then dimension it to the origin to get the height's fixed. I'll make it so that there's a 3/4 inch bore. And let's see, I want my V-belt channel here. I only want that to be 3/4 of an inch. And looks like things are getting kind of pulled around here. So what I'm going to do is add another angle dimension in between this line and this line so that I can set that, and I want it to be half of the 22, so it'd be 90 plus 11, which is 101 degrees. Then I need to dimension these lines up here, and I can zoom in a bit so we can see what we're doing. I'm going to make this guy just 1/4 inch. And I'll make this one 1/4 inch as well. So I could have used an equal relationship when I did this, but for now it's fine to just put an extra dimension on there. Let's see, I've got the height, the width. I need to dimension down here. We can see this line's undefined, and so that's because I haven't put a width on the bottom of the groove, and I'm going to make the bottom of my groove 0.375, so 3/8 of an inch. Next, I need to say how deep this pulley's going to be. I'll put it at 2 inches. And how big of a flat we'll put on it, and I'll put 3/4 of an inch. So now we have a fully defined sketch and we're almost ready to exit out, but to revolve, we have to identify an axis about which we want to revolve apart. So if I'm going to come up to my line tool, I'll click on the down arrow and then select the center line. And I'm going to grab the origin and come across horizontally with a line. Now you can see my sketch stays fully defined. I have the center line down here. My sketch is ready to go. And if I go to Features, I now can select the Revolve Boss Base. When I select Revolve Boss Base, it automatically knows that I have this center line in my sketch, so it's going to want to revolve the sketch around that center line. I'm going to click on Accept. And now I have a part that is just a revolution of that shape around the central axis. I can go ahead, I'm going to want to add some bolt holes to the front of this guy, so I'm going to open a new sketch. I'll get perpendicular and zoom in. And I want to show you how to make a construction circle. So I grab my normal circle tool and then I drag out a circle. And in the property manager, you can look down and see that there's a for construction box. If you go ahead and click on that, you can see that the circle turns to be dashed lines or the center line. Now I can add another circle right up here at the top and I'll dimension this guy be 3/8 of an inch probably, so 0.375. And if I then dimension my construction circle, I'm going to go ahead and make that 1 3/8, 1.375. Okay, you can see everything gets fully defined because there's a relationship on the center point of the circle to be on the quadrant of the construction circle. So I'm fully defined, so I can go ahead and do an extrude cut. I'll change the end condition to be through all on my extrude cut, and I get a hole through the part. Now, if we go up to linear pattern, I really want more circle holes here. So I can click on a circular pattern instead of a square pattern. And what this will allow me to do is to make a pattern of those holes that's circular. You have to select a central axis, and you can either do that by having an actual axis drawn or by selecting any cylindrical surface. So if I select that center hole, it automatically knows I want to put four holes around that. You may have your drawing look like this, where it just starts to put four right in a row, and it spaces them by degrees if you look over in the property manager. By clicking equal spacing, you'll be able to see what we're really after here. So I'll go ahead and click accept, and I have my four holes. Okay. So this has been a really quick introduction to the Revolve tool. There's lots more functionality that you can use in the Revolve tool, and I recommend you explore it a little bit. Thanks so much for watching.